Welcome back. Jake Bugg will be performing later. First, though, she's the pop princess who drives me crazy and was born to make you happy. Go nuts, go wild, and give it up for the one and only Britney Spears! You a nice drink. What would you like? I've got Cherryade, I've got J2O. J2O, okay,
yes,
love.
Thank you.
I was thinking I haven't got a butt milk, but I have. I was gonna have to use my teeth. That's all right, there you go. Let me give you a glass. There you go. We don't have ice on this show, sorry, love.
It's totally fine.
There you go.
Well, thank you.
Oh, all right, then, I'll just. Oh, I'll have the rest. I'll have your dregs. It don't matter, love. Now, listen, you, don't, you do that and then you get good sex. Have you heard that?
Oh, really?
Yes, okay. You look in my eyes and you go, cheers.
Cheers.
You mean, yeah. Oh. You don't have to have sex with me. You'll have good sex with... Yeah, yeah, don't worry. There's nothing in it. I haven't spiked it or anything. Okay. Do you know what? I can't believe you're on here.
Well, I love your show. Your show's great.
You're not just saying, don't mess with me, don't F with me.
I think you're so funny. You remind me a little bit of Austin Powers.
What a lovely compliment. Yeah, baby. Yeah. Do you know what? The first time I ever heard that, I was filling my car up at a petrol station, a gas station, and someone just drove their car straight by. Yeah, baby! I thought, what they say? And then I saw Austin Powers. I was like, you cheeky bastard! I can't help looking like this. When you tweeted about coming on the show, my Twitter account melted down, went absolutely crazy.
Oh,
can you
really?
Imagine going on your Twitter thing and seeing like about 5,000 tweets?
Oh, really?
Everyone went crazy.
That's so great, cool.
I thought I'd had like my sex tape had come out. It's out there, don't go looking. You've been over here all week, haven't you? Are you enjoying London? Do you like it?
I love it here. I think it's beautiful. It's so crisp, and the people are so jolly, and the food's great. And...
People are so jolly? Where the hell have you been? London's so jolly.
Yes, I love when you guys use your accent. It's like, I don't know.
It's not an accent, it's how we talk.
When you talk, it's really nice.
Have you been to Poundland yet? No, because I read in the paper. No, listen, I'm not saying you shop there, but you love going to 99 cent shops, don't you?
Yes, I do.
Yeah.
It's one of my things. Actually, I went today and I got these matches. They're actually this little. They're like the tiniest matches you've ever seen in your life, and they're so little, and you just go like that, and you almost burn your finger.
They sound a bit shit. What are staff like when you go into a Poundland and a night? Are they like, oh my God, it's Britney?
Not usually. Usually I have glasses on and no one recognizes me, and I just go in and I'm like really into what I'm doing, and I get into it, and it's really fun.
Yeah, oh, well, I never. Can I do that? The man, oh, that woman looks like, that woman buying the little matches looks like Britney. She's gonna burn her fingers. We've got to talk about your new single, Work, Bitch. Why do you call everyone bitch all the time?
It's like it's a street slang for everyone. Like, you know, and I get to work and like, you know, that's what you do when you get to work and it's like, you know, cool.
All right, okay.
Yeah.
Well, you're Britney. If I went around saying it, I'd get slapped to shit. Hi, bitch!
I don't call everyone that word. I just use it as, it's like kind of like a respect to the gays as a term of endearment.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, let's have a look at a clip. This is Britney in the brilliant Work Bitch. Now, the video is so raunchy, we can't watch it over in Britain before 10 p.m.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
I know, it's so raunchy. And is it true things were cut out of there?
Some specific shots were cut out, yes.
But what were they? Because, I mean, there's, like, people in gimp masks, there's people being whipped.
I can't tell you.
Is it that bad that you cut it out, that you can't even tell me on chatty? I mean,
what? It wasn't that bad, but it was pretty bad, yeah.
There's a car there. Was it, like, dogging? Not dogging. How can I explain dogging? It's like, you know, you go to a car park in a car, and if you like someone in the other car, you sort of flash your lights twice. And then you invite that person into your car?
No!
Yeah!
No, that's not what that is.
Well, I didn't know. I saw you there. You better work, bitch. And then this car turns up. I don't know. No, I'm innocent.
There's only three of those cars in America. There's only three. So we thought it would be really special to have this car come to the shoot.
Oh.
Because they're very rare.
Oh, my God. I tell you, if he flashed his lights in the car park, I'd get in with that car. Even if he was a minger, I'd be in that car. Right, bitch. In the video, yeah, I noticed you use a whip.
Yes.
How did you learn to use a whip?
We had a whip instructor come in and actually show me how to use it and to bring it around the back of my head and then actually use it. And if you do it the wrong way, you can actually hurt yourself and cut yourself with it because it's really powerful. They're really strong.
How good are you? Are you a bit like Indiana Jones? Like, you can get there, like, get an artifact off the wall and, like...
I'm not that good, no.
No, no.
I wish I was.
So that genuinely is you there? That's not, like, a wrist double?
That's me.
That poor dancer. I mean, are you allowed to do that?
Well, I really didn't hit her, though. She
there
was, like...
There she is, so... bending down, trying to find a contact lens. Was she scared about you whipping her?
No, because they told her that I wasn't going to actually hit her.
Oh, okay, okay. Now, you've said you're less comfortable now doing sexy stuff because you're a mum. What don't you like about it? Because we like it when you're slave for you.
Well, I think it's...
You like that?
Yeah, well, I knew it's a part of what I do and, yeah. Like, kind of like my job to bring sensuality and feeling to... you know, the table when I do videos and stuff, but I do feel a little silly sometimes.
Oh, no!
Yeah.
Oh! You shouldn't stop being sexy because you get... Look at Madonna, she wears leotards, up pants, doesn't she?
Yeah, she does.
Yeah.
I'll still work it out, but it's just, it's, you know, you feel kind of silly sometimes.
And you wrote this week that your album's called Britney Jean.
Yes.
Why have you called it that?
Well, that's what my family calls me, Britney Jean. It's like a term of endearment, and like if I've been bad, sometimes I say Britney Jean. What are you doing?
Oh.
You know? So it's like I wanted to share that with my fans. I just thought it would be kind of cool.
Because I'm like that. I've got this dog called Bev, and when she's naughty, I go Beverly. It's weird, isn't it? You do the long game. You put them, yeah, put them in the place. Good for you. You said it's your most personal album you've done. So what are we going to learn about the real Britney from it?
Well, the whole album is just... Will I Am actually co-produced it.
Oh, we love so, Will I Am.
Yeah, he directed me and guided me on the record really well, and we had a lot of fun. But most of the songs are about celebrating, having a good time. You know, I went through a breakup with this record, so some of the stuff that I went through with that is on the record as well. So, but it's just fun. It's a fun record.
Yeah. Do you understand what Will I Am says? Because I've had him on here, and it's like talking to a speak-your-wake machine or something. Is he like that with you, even with Britney?
He's, like, really, really funny to be with. Like, and he's so cool. Like, on his video shoot, like, when he had this walking scene where he just had to walk across the thing on a treadmill thing, and he just, like, walked so cool. And I was like, oh, my God, like, he's really cool. Yeah.
Now, listen, Will I Am has hinted that you'll be doing a track with Lady Gaga. I want a Chatty Man exclusive, bitch. Please say it's true. Do you know anything about this?
You have to wait and see.
What? Yeah. That's not fair!
Sorry.
I think it sounds like a yes to me. Later this year, you're starting a 2-year residency in Las Vegas. 2 years. Why did you decide to do Vegas and not go on tour? Do you like Vegas?
Oh, I love Vegas. I think it's fun. It's like all your friends and family come there for celebration. It's just like a, you know, a place to have a really good time. So I'm really excited.
And what can we expect from the show? Do you know what you're going to do yet?
Yeah, I'm in rehearsals right now. So we're kind of figuring out all the ropes right now, what I'm going to do.
Yeah. And it's going to have all your hits on, is it? Womanizer, womanizer, oh, I love it.
Yes.
Who's the person that goes, womanizer, at the end? It always freaks me out, you know, like when you do like over it, womanizer, womanizer, womanizer. You know. Who is that, Brittany? Who is it?
I don't know who that is.
My God, find out, it's scary.
I know. It is
scary. How much training are you going to do for your Vegas show? Because you're going to have to be fit for 2 years in Vegas.
Yeah, I have a lot of hard work ahead of me. I have, like, probably 4 to 5 hours of rehearsals every day. And then 2 days a week I have to work out. So it's going to be a lot of work.
You don't have to look too slim in Vegas, do you? Because, I mean, have you been there? I mean, some of the people, I mean, I've never looked slimmer there in my... in my honestly, it's true. In my holiday photos, I've never looked slimmer there. I'm like this. Honestly, people actually stop me in Vegas and say, are you eating? So what kind of training do you do? Is it true you box?
Yes, I box.
Go on then, punch me, go on.
I have a ring on, it's gonna hurt you.
Oh, yeah. No, it's fine. I'm a bare knuckle fighter, go on then. Is that how hard as you box?
I'm not gonna do it harder than that.
Come on! Punch the shit out of me. Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You're doing too hard.
Sorry.
Oh, I suppose I did ask for it. We've got to take a break there, Brittany, love. Join us again in a couple of minutes when Brittany will be cracking the whip round here and Jake Bugg will be performing. See you in part 4.